Hi everyone, I'm Eloy from Knowledge Sharing Tech. In this video, I want to show you how to install the whonix operating system on your Linux machine. In my example, I'm using Linux Ubuntu 22.04, but the instructions I'm going to show you apply also to any Linux distribution based on Debian. There are three main steps that you need to perform. The first step is to install VirtualBox on Linux. The second step is to download whonix and then import the appliances of whonix into VirtualBox. And the third step is to perform the initial configuration. So I'm going to show you all this. So now I'm going to start by showing you how to install VirtualBox on your Linux Ubuntu machine. If you want to go into the details of installing VirtualBox, I have done a previous video that will show you all the details for this installation. And I'm going to leave a link for this video in the description if you want to check it out. But here I'm going to give you the essential details that will get you up and running so that you can install the whonix operating system. First of all, on your Linux machine, you need to open a terminal window. To open a terminal window, press on your keyboard Ctrl, Alt, and T, and the terminal window will open. The first step in the installation of VirtualBox is to add the multiverse repository. So this is a command that you need to key in. Sudo add-apt-repository multiverse and end sudo apt-update. Press Enter. It will ask you for your password, so put your password and press Enter again. Here it will ask you to confirm that you want to add the multiverse repository. Simply press Enter and it will continue. The second command is that we need to make sure that Ubuntu is updated. So key in this command, sudo apt-upgrade, and hit Enter. Press Yes and Enter. Now the next step is to install VirtualBox. So let me clear the screen and key in this command to install VirtualBox, sudo apt-install VirtualBox, and press Enter. So press Y on your keyboard and Enter. By the way, I'm going to put all the commands in the description for your convenience. And if you're liking this video so far, please consider subscribing to my channel and giving this video a thumbs up. Now that VirtualBox is installed, let's install whonix. The first command we need to do is to install the curl command. So this is what we need to do. Once again, let's clear the screen and key in this command, sudo apt-install curl. So we need curl so that to fetch the whonix installer from the internet. And here's curl installed. Now we need to key in a command to get the installer of whonix from the internet. So this is a command that we need to type. It's a bit long. Curl dash dash tlsv1.3 space dash dash output space whonix dash installer dash xfce space minus minus url space https colon slash slash www.whonix.org slash installer dash dist and press Enter. So now we got the installer. So I'm gonna clear the screen once again. The next command is to import the whonix appliance from the internet and then create the two virtual machines. You know whonix needs two virtual machines, so it will import the whonix gateway and it will import the whonix workstation into VirtualBox. So this is the command, bash space dot slash whonix dash installer dash xfce and press Enter. So you're gonna get this message. Press Tab on your keyboard and then press Enter to agree. So you see this is where it is importing the appliances into VirtualBox. So at the end, it will ask you if you want to launch whonix now. I'm going to say no because I'm going to show you how to launch it from VirtualBox. So I just pressed N and then Enter. So now I'm going to minimize the terminal window and let's open VirtualBox. So you find it under your applications here. So here is VirtualBox. Let me open it. And you see that the two whonix machines were imported into VirtualBox. Always for whonix, you need to start the gateway first and then the workstation. So I'm gonna start the gateway, just click on it and then click on start. So at first start, it will ask you to agree. So click on understood and then click on next and finish. So now it is asking you if you want to connect to the Tor network. So I'm going to keep it on connect and then click on next and click on next. So now it is connecting to the Tor network, and this is only the first time you start the gateway machine. So it says here connected to the Tor network. At this stage here, click finish. So I'm going to minimize it. And here we need to start the workstation machine. So let's double click on it to start it. So this is also the first time you open the workstation machine. It will ask you to agree on the agreements. So click here on understood and then click next and finish. And here you need to be patient. It is telling you that it might take up to 5 minutes so that it will connect to the Tor network through the gateway. So now this is the next step. It is performing a system check. So now it's telling you that you can update some packages. I'm going to click OK now. I'm not going to update the packages. I'm going to show you just how you can browse the internet now anonymously using Unix on your Linux machine. So let's click on the menu here and let's go to internet. So web browser. And let me go, for instance, to my website, Knowledge Sharing Tech. So this is a website working. Now I'm going to show you two important things that you need to do after you installed Unix and you verified that it is working. So let's close the website and let's go to terminal once again. So terminal, it is here. And the first thing is to change the password. So the default credentials of a Unix installation, the user is user and the password is change me in small letters. To change the password, this is what you need to do. Type in the terminal window password. So P-A-S-S-W-D, press enter. So here put the current password, which is change me, press enter, and put the new password, put a strong password, of course, press enter when you put it, and put it once again, and press enter. So now the password for the default user is changed, and this is a very important security measure to do. Now, everything I'm showing you here on the workstation virtual machine, you need also to do it on the gateway machine. I'm not gonna do it on the gateway machine here so that this video will not be too long, but bear in mind that you need to do it here on the gateway machine also, the exact same things. So changing the password and then updating the installation. So now I'm gonna show you how to update the Unix installation. Let me clear the screen first and key in this command to update the installation, sudo apt update and n sudo apt upgrade space minus y and hit enter. So here it is updating, and remember that to update your Unix installation frequently so that you keep all the information and all the files updated to prevent security breaches. If you have any comments or questions, please don't hesitate to put them in the comments section below, and I'll be more than happy to answer all your comments and all your questions. I hope that you liked this video and you found it useful. If you did, please share it, subscribe to my channel, and give this video a thumbs up. I would really appreciate it, and this will help my channel greatly. And this way, you'll not miss my future videos. I'm Eloy from Knowledge Sharing Tech. See you in the next video.